Well, Clinigen is a specialty pharmaceuticals and service businesses group with offices in the UK, the US and Japan. It's just released its full year results and its chief executive, Peter George, is here to talk us through the highlights and where the company is going in the future. Well, Peter, what was the financial highlight of the period?
Well, for me, the highlight was that all three operating businesses contributed to really strong profit results. They were up 20%, and like-for-like revenues up 7.5%. And it was a really good set of results. We're very pleased with them. We bought two new products in the period, and we've got a product that we bought in the prior year relicensed in Europe. So everything we said we were going to do last year, we did. And that's very satisfying.
So you talk, for those people that don't know about you, you talk about the three operating centres. What are they?
Well, we do clinical trial drug supply, where we supply bulk drugs for clinical trials, the comparator drugs, the drugs that new drugs are compared to. We supply unlicensed medicines, and these are supplied with the company's permission, and they're pre-launch, or they're where they haven't been launched in a market. And then we have our own products, which we started with one product when we IPO'd, and we've now got five products, and we're targeting 10.
And when did you IPO?
September 2012, so 2 years ago.
And how many customers have you accrued within your portfolio, and who are your clients?
Well, we've got clients all over the world. We deliver to more than 75 countries around the world. And they're different customers for different parts of the business. We have pharmaceutical companies are our customers. And then we've got patients and their clinicians are our customers. We delivered something like 370,000 units last year. So there's a lot of individual customers all over the world.
What prompted the rise in the dividend?
Well, we have a progressive dividend policy. And so we are looking to each year to progress that forward. And we made that statement when we IPO'd, and we want to stick to that policy.
Have you ever reneged on anything that you've promised investors in the past?
I make every effort not to do so. That's my job. If we say we're going to do something, we make every effort to go and do it. I mean, not to the detriment of everything else, but once you said you're going to do something, focus on doing it.
Now, when we spoke to you recently, you said that you were focused mainly on profits rather than revenues.
Yeah.
Is this still the case?
Well, I think what we'd had, in particularly in our clinical trial supply business, is the profits had reduced in that year. They were down to about 12.8%, and we'd always promised they'd be 15%. And this year we've managed to get those back to 15%. Now, in that business, there's been a drop in revenue, but that happens. It's a lumpy business. It goes up and down depending on how expensive the drugs you buy are. And we did £24 million worth of hepatitis C drugs in the prior year, which we didn't repeat. But the profit is significantly better.
I love that word lumpy. I'm not really sure I know what it means.
No.
What does it refer to?
Well,
what's the cause of it, lumpiness?
Yeah, what we do is we buy drugs for a clinical trial. So if there's 1,000 patients on a clinical trial and they're being given a cheap drug, it doesn't cost us very much to acquire that. And if they're given a very expensive drug, it's much bigger purchase price, but you do that at a lower margin. So you each purchase could be anywhere between 100,000 and 30 million. So, and we don't have any say in which drugs are used for a clinical trial. They're just the drugs that are requested. So if you had 30 million requests and 300,000 requests, that's pretty lumpy business.
Now, you've used the word purchase. How acquisitive a company are you?
We're very acquisitive for the right products. We say that we will always revitalize a product. So that means that we'll at least double the turnover in a 3-year period. So with our first product, Foscovir, it's grown nearly sixfold in 3 years. And then we've got Cardioxane, Savine, Ethiol, Verbativ, all of which we think we can revitalize. And that we do that through new markets, new pricing, new indications, and if a drug has been has some safety issues associated with it, then we will work with the regulatory authorities to overcome those and give it to a broader population.
Now, this is probably the toughest question I'm going to ask you. Now, I know that you were a pathologist and that you worked in the NHS. Would you want the NHS to be one of your customers?
The patients in the NHS are, but we do a relatively small percentage of our business is in the UK. About 3% of our business is in the UK. So yes, we do want the NHS, but the nice thing about our business is our risk is spread over 75 countries. So, you know, if something's not going positively in an individual geography, it tends to have a minimal effect on us rather than, if we had all of our eggs in one basket.
And finally, what can we expect from Clinigen in the next 12 months?
We are definitely continuing to look for more products. The products that we bought in the last 12, 18 months, I think there's some really exciting revitalization opportunities there, particularly with cardioxane. And we're working with key opinion leaders all over the world to get that product recognized as a standard of care. So we've recently had 8 papers published supporting its use in pediatrics, which is I'm very excited about. And also we're looking to extend our global footprint. At the moment we use quite a lot of partners around the world, and we're looking to actually place our own presence in Asia, in South America, possibly in the Africas as well, to make direct contact with patients and our end customers rather than using third parties.
So to use your words, revitalization, recognition, is there another word you would use to describe Clinigen?
An exciting place to work.
That's lots of words, but I'll forgive you.
We all of the staff are fantastic, and we have a really good atmosphere and just enjoy it. And that's why we do well, I think.
Peter George, Chief Executive of Clinigen, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.